once again of our top three, Norris, Schwartzman, and Max Verstappen. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head you today to one of the jewels of the Arab world, Jeddah, one of the biggest cities in Saudi Arabia, second only to Riyadh, gateway to Mecca, and one of the biggest ports in the region. And now, host to the Saudi Arabia Grand Prix. So let's take a look at the topographical map of the Jeddah street circuit. As you can see, a number of challenging corners for the drivers to master here. We'll see just how much the teams have benefited from their time spent in practice this weekend. And like many street circuits, this track has the potential to punish drivers that get it wrong. Let's hope we avoid any safety cars today. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Lando Norris will lead us away from pole position, and Robert Schwartzman completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Moore, Oscar Piastri, and Sainz, Perez, Gasly, Bottas, and Charles Leclerc, Stroll, Russell, Mick Schumacher, and Vettel, Tsunoda, Tictum, Esteban Ocon, and Alex Albon, Joe, and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. And with me as usual is Anthony Davidson. Can I get your take on Haas? We have a number of changes to the aerodynamic regulations this year, and the signs haven't looked good for them so far in terms of getting to grips with those changes.
There are a few downcast looks within the team this weekend. I think they've been hit fairly hard by the new regs. But this is only the first step down a long road of development, and even if they don't maximise their points today, there are plenty more up for grabs this season.
Launch map is good, but we need to learn the gears, so go into each one when you can. We're going to need some work on the brakes, so put some energy into them and warm the tyres as well, please. Okay, incredible parking there, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get good launch as the race starts. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient. need to worry about the tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good. job, mate. That's a fantastic podium. Super driving, really strong pace. I'm really happy. Well deserved.
It was a tough race at times, but they've held on to take a great victory for McLaren today. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we witnessed today.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations, and it's going to be McLaren picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for that fantastic performance. Let's see how the driver's standings have changed. Despite the best efforts of our championship leader, that lead has taken a bit of a knock today. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I have to give it to Moore. They did a great job at getting the most out of their tyres without losing pace, something that's a very handy skill to have in modern day Formula One.
Let's move on to the constructors. Alpine's lead continues to grow at the head of the table. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.